unto your God. We will unto your Maker and just appreciate him, glorify him, exalt him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for making us to see this day. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord. 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 God said that you tell somebody, I will make way for you there. Have no more fears. I will make way for you there. Thank you, Lord. I want you to open your mouth and pray and say, Father, I am grateful for your faithfulness in my life, for your mercy towards me. I am grateful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want you to open your mouth and pray and say, Father, if there is any sin or any iniquity in my heart that will not allow you to hear me, forgive me, have mercy on me, and blot out that iniquity from my heart. The Bible said that if you regard iniquity in your heart, the Lord will not hear you. If there is any sin or iniquity in my heart that will not allow my prayer, we have come to pray. What the essence of spending time praying when there is a blockage already? Father, any sin, any iniquity in my heart, please lay it away from me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. For all you have done, and they have to be bleeding. But that happens when the attribute of man, or the attitude of man, or the habit of man, called forgetfulness, is activated. Man has this bad habit that the scripture has always pointed out, that man forgets. God does not forget you, but man easily forgets. One of the undoings of the Israelites while they were on their journey to the promised land happened to be this singular bad habit of man: forgetfulness. And it can be very famous with the book of Psalm 41 verse 9. David, he lamented when it was somebody that was close to him that betrayed him. He said, even, can you give us on the big screen, whoever is behind the big screen, first. Even my own, give me King James, okay. Yeah, my own familiar friend, in whom I trusted, which did eat of my bread, and lifted up his heel against me. One of the things that you need to ask God for is to give you this heart of remembrance. Heart of remembrance is very heavy. Man, even Jesus Christ, God suffered this from man. In the book of Psalm 78, 42 and 43, Psalm 78, the Bible said that they forgot all the miracles that he had done. They started complaining. They started telling that, leave us alone. And he prayed God. He remembered not. This attitude of forgetfulness of man is an, nor the day when he delivered them from the enemy. 43, and that made God not to be happy. How he had wrought his signs in Egypt and his wonder in the field of Zion. But not David. No wonder God said, this is the man after my heart. Even when he will be going through unpleasant time, he will make himself to be remembering that even though I'm going through bad time, God is still good. Because I remember the thing that he had done. Psalm 103:2-5. Psalm 103. He will be telling himself, forget not his benefits. Psalm 103:2-5, please. Psalm 103:2-5. Can you give us on the big screen? Big screen first. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. I did not say two to five, please. Who forgiveth all thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases? Who redeemed thy life from destruction? Who crowned thee with loving kindness and tender mercies? Who satisfied thy mouth with good things so that thy youth is renewed like the eagle? David had this attribute of not forgetting, and it helped him. Now, the particular time he was about to confront a big challenge, Goliath. He sees you the same thing. When they were telling him that you are not able, he said, I remember how God delivered me. 1 Samuel 17:37. 1 Samuel 17:37. He said, the same God that delivered, he remembered, he made himself to remember. David said, moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said unto David, go, and the Lord be with thee. This attribute of remembrance, very key. Without it, it's very easy to misbehave. That's why David said that, how could you have forgotten? In fact, from where I'm from, when somebody that you did not expect will do something to you, they will make a statement, Obama devil. It means that it ought not to have been you. With all I've been doing for you, will you turn your back against me? If anybody, I don't even mind. You should not. Meaning think that that person has lost the sense of remembrance. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 24, 6 and 7, 1 Samuel 24, 6 and 7, he had the opportunity to kill King Saul, but he activated the remembrance that God anointed. In fact, he has lost favor with God, but he made himself to remember when God still anointed him, and that prevented him from doing something wrong. Even though all the people around him, they were encouraging him, this is the opportunity to kill him. He said, how can I do this thing against God anointed? He remembered that God anointed him. And he said unto the men, the Lord forbid that I should do this thing unto my master. He remembered that he was unto the master, even though he had changed him out of the town. The Lord anointed to stretch forth my hand against him. See, he is the anointed of God. You need that prayer this year. Because there will be some time that you'll find yourself, I won't promise you that you'll find yourself in some situations that are not paradise. But that remembrance of who God has been to you, what God has done for you, or some things that person has done for you, will stay your hand from doing all your feeling is trying to get you to do at that time. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, the act of remembrance to always do the right thing at the right time, please activate in me. Activate that act of remembrance. Without that act, it's very easy. It's very easy. Thank you, God. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. Blessed be the name
of the Lord.
You are worthy. May God help that person not to miss the time again. If you look at the story of Elijah, God gave him provision through raven birds in 1 Kings chapter 17, I think from 4 down to 8. Gave him provision through bed. Bed will fly and will bring bread, cake to him. And he was eating and was drinking water by the brook. But he got to a time, the brook dried up. And God spoke to him again. Go to a widow. And the widow will be the next. This year, God may be giving you another instruction towards a direction. Don't be the kind of person that the way I've been doing it, that is how I'll be doing it forever and ever. Those kind of people, they miss out from God. God will have told you to anoint Saul. Once upon a time, he could be telling you, put your oil in the oil again. I've rejected Saul. Go to David and anoint him. God could have told you, go and sacrifice Isaac. On the third day, he had changed his mind. Stay in your hand. And somebody said that, he told me, he will kill who God does not want you to kill at that time. Hence, you need him to lead the way. It's somebody that knows the way that should lead the way now. In the book of Job, chapter 28, verse 23. Job 28, 23. Remember that God is the one that knows the way. He understands it. He knows the place, that place of your breakthrough. All the places that everything that you have been asking for, you can get. He knows. Why shouldn't he be the one that you say, please, oh, this year, oh, lead me to the places of my breakthrough. And to be easy. God understanded the way thereof, and he knoweth the place thereof. And he also told us in Psalm 37, verse 23, Psalm 37, 23, verse said that the steps of a good man are under that. We are not combining the two scriptures together now. He understands the way, and he knows the place, and he can also order. Why don't we now tell him to order ourselves? Please be fast on the beast queen first. That is the one I'm reading. On the beast queen first, before the other one. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighted in his ways. Let's open our mouth and pray and say, Father, all throughout this year, make me good in your sight, and order my steps, honor the places of my blessing, the places of my victory, the places of my settlement, the places of my fruitfulness, the places of my joy. Order my steps. Order my steps, Lord. Marakashana la baba. Order my steps. Let me be at the right place at the right time. Let me don't be religious, but let me respond to your spirit leading. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Anytime I call you,
answer.
Any door I know. In that scripture, I saw that something that a person has been given can be lost and not be recovered. Ah, good people in your life, when you mistreat them, can be lost. I'm trying to get them back. Sometimes it does not work. Sometimes it works, but sometimes when the camel's back is broken, it does not work again. In the book of Hebrews chapter 12, 16 and 17. Hebrews chapter 12, 16 and 17. They were giving the account of Esau after he had lost the birthright. The Bible said that with tears, he did everything later to get it back from where? Jacob had already, it was already spammed. Any other thing, okay, let us bless you, sir. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright. For ye know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected. For he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully out. He wanted it back, but it was too late. And I said, there's something that if somebody loses it, the best thing is not to lose
those things. Queen Vashti, she lost her throne and she lost it forever. In the book of Esther chapter 1, 10 to 12, Esther chapter 1, the king, her husband, sent for her that they should call her to go and show herself to the guests, being proud of her beauty. He said, I'm not coming. Me too, I'm having my own feast with my ladies. And the thing were there, they said, disgrace. Shame. Nagin, O king, calling the queen. The queen did not answer in front of all of us. And they now advise him, if you don't do something about this attitude of rebellion or disobedience, all our wives now, because they will hear it, they will start doing the same thing. Take action now. Remove her from that room and bring another person there. She never regained that throne again. You will never lose any good thing or any good person God has blessed you with any attitude of yours. On the seventh day, when the heart of the king was merry with wine, he commanded Mehuma, Bista, Abona, Bita, and Abata, Zeta, and Kakas, and seven chamberlains that served in the presence of Ahasuerus the king, to bring Vashti the queen before the king with the crown royal, to show the people and the princes her beauty, for she was fair to look on, beautiful, talented, gifted. But the queen Vashti refused to come at the king's commandment by his chamberlains. Therefore was the king very wroth, and his anger burned in him. Go to 19. The advice that they gave to the king, the counselors around him. If it pleased the king, let there go a royal commandment for him, and let it be written among the laws of the Persian and the Medes, that it be not ordered that Vashti come no more before King Ahasuerus, and let the king give a royal estate unto another that is better than her. Esther 2:17. Esther 2:17. Even though they did not say that she, like Esau, sought that thing, she did pride, you know, she would be. I would just wonder if she would be in that same land and Esther would be ruling. Which house would she be living inside that same land? How would people say, ah, this was the queen before? And the king loved Esther above all the women, and she obtained grace and favor in his sight more than all the virgins. So that he set the royal crown, the one they removed from her, upon her head and made her queen instead of Vashti. You will never lose any good thing or any good person God has brought into your life. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me to always appreciate every good person or any good thing that you have blessed me with, and never to lose it in the name of Jesus. Even if it's a job, if it's a gift, if it's a sibling, if it's a friend, if it's whoever, let me, that is you that brought into my life, please let me never mistreat or disregard to the point that I will not lose favor. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. But in case we have lost anything, the mercy of God will help us. We will win and we will recover. Amen. We will recover whoever is good in our life that somehow unknowingly, carelessness or whatever had made us to lose in the name of Jesus. Amen. Because in Joel chapter 2:25, the Bible said that I will restore all. It may not work for everybody, but it will work for us. Amen. We will get back anything that we have lost. Amen. Imagine for 7 years a king was was became an animal, and nobody occupied that throne. King Nebuchadnezzar, God preserved it. I'm still amazed. 7 years, somebody was the king, and he was not ruling. In the year, and until he got his senses back, and God brought him back. Say, oh, what will make in a nation no president for? For 1 month, said, people will be agitated. Let the vice president, let him take over. But God ensured the body took over. Anything that is seen as if you have lost, or any good person that is seen as if has gone away from you, maybe based on your attitude or something that you did not know, let the mercy of God speak for you.
Amen.
He said, I will restore all the years that have been stolen. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, release your mercy to me and restore all the years that Pharaoh, caterpillar, has stolen from me, and anything that has stolen, restore the years. Restore the years. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Have your way, Lord.
Have your way.
Have your way, Lord. God have his way in your life.
Amen.
And let anything that is blocking your way be removed.
Amen.
Let this year usher you into that breakthrough that you have long sought. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
We're going to be praying. I'm begging you, the theme of this prayer session, maybe we just call it, don't forget to remember. Don't forget, because we are going to be talking about, you know, you can forget what somebody has done for you in the time. It's very easy. Man has that attitude, you quickly forget. And in the spur of the moment or things on, you just change. That let me be like David. That will be making himself that no, I should. Even if this guy is misbehaving, let me not forget to all the things that God has anointed him. Allow anybody to play God in your life this year. What did I say? Nobody saved you but Jesus. The one that has blessed you is God. Don't allow, because we live in a world that makes people that are in relationship with God and they are improving their relationship with God to look like fools, like mumu. Want to kill yourself? You are going to church? We live in that kind of world. Demonically infested world that will project itself even and the people around you to give you wrong counsel, to reduce your fire, to reduce your commitment. Don't allow anybody. And God will always say, hey, now that you are big, don't forget. Don't forget. That's why I said that the theme of this prayer session, it just don't, because it's very easy for you to forget. If somebody says that, I'm not going to be in relationship with you if you don't spend, if you don't reduce your commitment in that your church that you go in serving your God, let the person go.
Yes,
a better person will come.
Yes,
because nobody, the person he or she did not save you. If Jesus Christ that saved you, and nobody has the right to tell you to reduce your commitment in appreciation of what God has done, remembering how God took you, all the things that you could have been penalized and you could not even be alive now, that he saved you, that no. Even if I give my life back to him, it's not too much. I am not saying that the things that I'm doing for him is too much. It's the devil that is using that person, regardless of how close or how that person is to you, to tell you to disregard God. In the book of Deuteronomy chapter 6, I think 10 to 12, Deuteronomy 6 said that after you have filled, you have your houses, you have them, don't forget who bless you. Because this attitude of not forgetting, say, I'll try self. Let me relax. It's very easy. And what a person has can be lost. And it shall be when the Lord thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he swear unto thy father, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give thee great and goodly city, which thou bidest not. And houses full of all good things which thou fillest not, and wells deep which thou diggest not, vineyard and olive trees which thou planted not, when thou shalt have eaten and be full, then beware. God was the one speaking, they would say that beware, meaning that the tendency is always high. Let thou forget the Lord, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage. Don't forget. Anybody that is not down with my commitment to God, let the person go. Anybody that said that I must reduce, I don't care who that person is, I must, because I remember where I'm coming from. I remember how I would have been lost in sin. I remember some things that I did that I could have been penalized, but he still showed me mercy. Is it your blood that will save me? And I said that I should relax. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me to set my priorities right and be focused on you throughout this year, regardless of the comment or opinion of any other person. Help me to set my priorities right and be focused on you, and let me not allow my commitment towards you dwindle or reduce. In fact, let it be on the increase, because your grace will be on the increase. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. David said, thou anointed my head with oil and my cup runneth over. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, right now, anoint my head with oil and let that be abundance in every area of my life. Abundance, financial abundance, peace abundance, joy abundance, health abundance. Anoint me that will attract abundance into my life. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed, say, Father, let it be well with this land. Prosper this land. Help our leaders to do the right thing. And let me eat the good of this land. Let it be well with this land. Prosper this land. Help our leaders to do the right thing. And let me eat the good of this land. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please help me. Every member of my family and friends to make heaven gloriously and with ease in the fullness of our time. Open your mouth and just pray that prayer as we round up. And also as we begin to package your offering. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give our praise. Not just with spiritual blessing, you have blessed us with physical blessing that we can bring something tangible unto you. Please receive this from us in the name of Jesus. And throughout this year, help us to remember the vital things we need to remember to keep on flying higher. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. God bless you. Please be seated briefly. If this is your first time of coming to worship with us on a morning service like this, we love you.
and you are in the house, just wave your hand to Jesus. Oh, let's celebrate our brother and God of God. Amen. Just wave to Jesus. God bless you. This is the Redemption Center Church of God. Okay, it's all right. This is the Redemption Center Church of God. Kingsway Palace Area 1, Zone 1, Lagos Province 3, Region 19. And here, holiness is our watchword. Evangelism, our supreme task, and excellence, the way we roll. And God will cause you to roll with us, with all these virtues in the name of Jesus. They will reach out to you with something that you will help us to feel. Birthday celebration! Ebube! Another year in the life story. It shall be the best years for him so far. That God will honor him on all sides, favor him on all sides, and make all things to work together for his good. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Amen.
Stop.
Bam. 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 Praise the Lord. Fresh Fire Conference starts when? On Monday through Friday. Please, let's come. And during Fresh Fire Conference, we always encourage us to write our desires for the year, what we want. And on the Friday, we'll drop them or we'll send them. Some people that are online said, some of them send them to our messenger. We help them to print out and we drop for them. At the end of the whole program, we'll set them up at least. After we must have prayed in the Holy Ghost and worship God around it. And God will bless us. Later today, we are going to be having faith clinic service here. Don't miss it. It's going to be extremely powerful again. And tomorrow, what is happening here? In the morning. Early favor hour. What edition? Holy Ghost edition. In the evening, come. Holy Ghost service. What kind of something? Factual or online? Okay, good. So please connect and God will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any other announcement? Pastor, I know some people will be saying that anytime I dress like this, I'm going somewhere. I want to go into my office. I tell you, I'm going somewhere. I see a call yesterday night that at Victory as I'm leading the prayer 7:30 to 8 o'clock. Before the, I'm not supposed to, but I just received the call yesterday that you stand for somebody that ought to be in this stand. And God will help us in Jesus' name. Let's rise to our feet. I decree into your life that as you go into favor. You enter into breakthrough. You enter into fruitfulness. You enter into your joy. Working well for you before you start working well. Amen. And before the end of today, let there be reason for you to rejoice. Amen. For you to testify. Amen. Of God's goodness. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. You know the song that came to my heart, but we share the grace because all my life you have been faithful. Let's share the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you.